From the NFL to the Premier League, sport is increasingly big business. And like any other industry, technology plays a huge role in helping teams and athletes gain and maintain a competitive edge. And it's not just on the field. In this episode, we speak to some of the leading names in sport about why fan engagement matters and how the best in the business are using tech to build better sporting experiences.
This game is real. You can't fake it, you can't script it. It's the greatest reality show on TV right now.
Spectator experience is kind of key, because without spectators, you don't have a viable sport.
They're our lifeblood, right? They're the ones that kind of keep us ticking, and we're here every day to put on a great show for them.
Sport is nothing without its fans. While on-field performance is critical in a results-oriented business, what happens off the field of play is becoming equally important in defining success. Creating new audiences, as well as catering to the needs and desires of existing fans, is critical to the long-term health of a team or sport.
Our number one goal when we bring fans into this arena is to create the best possible fan experience we can. We want to wow our fans every time they walk out the door and said, you know what, if I was a borderline Cavs fan when I came in, I am now a hardcore Cavs fan when I left, because this experience here was second to none.
We live in a world of a lot of intellectual clutter, and what we are trying to make sure that we do is deliver a great experience that does not detract from the main reason they're here, which is the game, but be able to create a shared environment so they can expand their experience and share it with others.
Consumption is changing very fast. The whole media landscape, obviously, very fragmented. Lots and lots of different services, different ways of consuming. Everybody competing so much for your attention. And golf has to be, you know, in that competition, making sure that whatever it is that we're offering is a competitive force for whatever else is going on.
But with technology rapidly changing the way we consume sports and interact with other fans, how are sports teams responding? How is tech helping to transform the fan experience?
85% of the people that walk through our door are equipped with a smartphone. So immediately, we're tasked with having to battle with another device that is pulling at the user's attention from the second they walk in the door. One of the first things that we tried to set up our approach when I joined the team in July of 2013 is, okay, let's focus on our mobile application as a means to really start to drive and change and impact fan behavior, and look at it really from the curb-to-curb experience.
In response, the Cavaliers have put mobile technology front and center of their approach, using it to offer everything from mobile ticketing and concession stand offers to in-game statistics and instant video replays. Key is their use of proximity marketing and beacon technology to provide all important context.
How do we focus to be able to deliver the right experience at the right time? We don't want that fan constantly being buried in their phone while they're taking an event. We want them to be consumed by the environment they're in, and that process is going to spur that fan engagement that we want.
Our whole stadium here at AT&T Stadium was built for fan engagement, from the giant video board, which basically has really redefined the way people watch a sporting event, to the experience that fans have when they come in, when they walk through the tunnel and they see the players around them and they can slap a high five, they can get a picture, to really be able to create that one-on-one engagement with the fans and bring them into the experience as opposed to sitting back and watching it.
And while technology is now impacting every facet of professional sports, without doubt, the most visible is in the way it helps teams interact with their fans.
The first and most important thing is about being connected. At this day and age, everyone wants to be connected, and they want to share that experience with others. They want to say, look at my great experience, and I'm here, but you're not. They want to be able to take that photo. They want to be able to tweet. They want to be able to text. They want to connect to Wi-Fi. And here in our building, we have the largest backbone to do so, from a Wi-Fi capacity bigger than any other venue in the world. And we can accommodate that for over 100,000 fans, and to be able to do that under one roof is really extraordinary. Then once you're connected, how does that experience change for you as a user? It might make it more user-friendly so that you can speed through a concession line or a ticket line. But for us, we want to make sure that we have technology for a purpose and not just technology for technology's sake.
Golf faces a slightly different challenge, with little in the way of fixed infrastructure on the course itself. Even so, the sport has come a long way in a short space of time since mobile phones were banned at the 2010 Ryder Cup. At last year's tournament, they were essential to the fan experience.
So there's a lot of different ways that we can help people experience the game on the golf course and get to and from the venue more easily. The really big enabler of technology is in the spectator experience, you know, through mobile devices. So you've got everything at your fingertips, you know, like our sat nav for the golf course, the live leaderboards, all the player data. You know, we're working on some applications so that you can, using GPS, point your device at someone who's coming up the fairway, bring up all their statistics. You know, using location services to get people to maybe get 2-for-1 in the hamburger stand or a free beer or whatever it is. You know, those are the kind of things I think we can do a lot more of as we go forward.
I think we deliver an experience that hits the needs for every level of fan. If you want to be a hardcore fan that interacts and is always dialed into the technology in the arena, you have the ability to do that. If you're a casual fan, you can go in and get some great statistics, maybe check out a mobile video replay, and then that can be the extent of your experience. But we want to be able to provide a platform, I think, that is littered from top to bottom across the board with the right pieces for our fans to engage.
But of course, it's not just the experience of those attending the game itself that is important. Technology now enables sports to reach an increasingly global fan base.
When we look at technology, it has to really be meant for all screens. So the millennial is watching smart TV at home, and they're, you know, they have their laptop in which they're hopping on occasion. They've got their tablet and they've got their smartphone. How do we deliver a consistent experience across all those platforms? So when they are thinking about the Cavs or NBA basketball or Kyrie Irving or LeBron James or Matthew Dellavedova or whatever it may be, we're top of mind. We have to break through the clutter, and hopefully we're part of that experience.
We know that the value of sport is very much in live, because watching sport when you know the outcome is a lot less compelling. But we're also seeing that, you know, live for the next generation might not necessarily mean watching it all the time. Live just means knowing what's happening all the time. And, you know, a timeline type experience with pictures and comments, and, you know, also knowing what people are saying and thinking, rather just as opposed to just what's happening. They decide what they want to watch and how they want to watch it and where they're going to consume it.
Statistically, only 7% of NFL fans actually enjoy their team in a stadium. You know, the other 93% are consuming or participating in their fan engagement through technology, through television, through their phones, through social media, through websites and beyond. So traditional marketing, we have a limit, but with technology, we have no limit. So we can expand who we are as a brand, you know, from our borders to beyond to internationally with all the content that we have to deliver. So it allows us to build a deeper connection with our fans, not only in stadium, but around the country and around the globe as well.
It highlights the growing importance of content and establishing the best ways to deliver it in order to keep fans engaged with relevant and timely information wherever they are.
Our fans are looking at any type of content that we can create that helps tell the story or humanize the brand behind who our players and who our team is. What is the team's personality? The beauty of a team is every year it has a different story, right? You know, the first game of every season, every team is in the same place. They're at 0-0. Everybody has high expectations. The story begins with the ebb and flow of the season after that. And we're documenting that and providing that information to our fans on a real-time basis wherever they are.
Content for us is key, is how can you get that content to where the user wants to actually share it, and how do you deliver content that's different in-game than you might see on television. One of those aspects, we have a 360 technology that allows us to deliver replays where you can see completely around the actual play of game. We have over 3,500 televisions around the venue that give information not only for data, for general data of concession location, to replays, to sponsor integration. They're used for a variety of things. So that is certainly a backbone for us to be able to deliver messaging.
In an era where people's attention span is so limited, it's very, very important to get into the right medium to address these people. And for the first time, all sports organizations, not just ours, we are really dealing with the end consumer in a very real way, quite possibly for the first time. Digital technology enables us to be having that dialogue directly with the end consumer. We're trying to bring a lot of people in by using the more quirky moments on the European tour on our YouTube channel. Some of the stunts we've done with the players, like clay pigeon shooting with a five iron and shooting down the clay. Things like this have proved incredibly successful, and people say, wow, I never realized golf was like this. And I think, we can draw people in that way.
But while the benefits are huge, the cost of investing in such technologies remains significant. So how do you measure the returns? Where do you find the wins?
We don't go in to every piece of technology we invest into looking for a return. It's not about ROI. It's about doing the right thing for our fans.
What I think is an obvious return on investment for us is the fans keep coming back. And when you have a full house and you have a sellout crowd game after game after game, you must be doing something right. Technology allows us to actually listen to our fans, for them to give us direct feedback, for them to give us immediate feedback. Even in game, they can let us know that we're either out of toilet paper in a restroom or that the line's too long in a certain concession stand, and we can respond to that in real time, which is very important. But hearing what the fans have to say and being able to create that game experience in and around what they want is really where the sweet part lies.
You're not always going to win. You're going to make mistakes. Not every piece of technology is going to be a home run, but what's important is you learn from that, and again, you go back to listening to your fans, and if you listen to them, you're going to be able to build a platform that is going to resonate over time. And when that happens, you now have your fans becoming brand advocates on your behalf, selling the brand forward, and that alone has a ton of marketing capital behind that.